Hi gang, here's a short fun science project about the photoelectric effect and how the photoelectric effect works. I've been wanting to do this for a while, and while working on larger projects, now was a good time. We start with an electroscope. This is an easy to make one, and one of my very first videos shows how you can make it yourself. I bought some zinc from an online science store. Just search for zinc metal electrode. Clean the oxide layer off the zinc using some steel wool or fine sandpaper. Place the zinc on top, such that it's in electrical contact with the electroscope's terminal. Then charge up a glass with a positive charge. I'm doing that using the triboelectric effect, by rubbing it with a piece of vinyl cut from leftover window blinds. The cleaner the glass is, the better this works. Then bring that glass near the zinc, but not touching it. Touch any of the metal on the electroscope with your finger, and, with the glass still near the zinc, remove your finger. Notice what happens to the aluminum foil leaves down here when I pull the glass away. They spread apart. Next, get a black light, which is a fluorescent lamp that gives off ultraviolet light. This one came from Home Depot a number of years ago. There are also incandescent light bulbs sold as black lights, but they don't seem to work. You've probably seen these black lights before. They're popular at parties for making things glow, even spooky things. With the electroscope raised a bit, to be closer to the ultraviolet light, I let the ultraviolet light shine onto the zinc. Watch what happens to the leaves down here. With this fluorescent lamp, it happens slowly, since there aren't a lot of photons to start with. But this is how much the leaves moved back together after 2 minutes and 26 seconds. How does the photoelectric effect work? When a photon of ultraviolet light arrives at a zinc atom, that gives enough energy for an electron to break free and fly away. In the electroscope, the only reason the leaves are spread apart is because we charged it with more negative electrons than positive protons. So the leaves are negatively charged and repel each other. But as we lose electrons due to the photoelectric effect, there are fewer and fewer electrons overall, including at the leaves. They're becoming less and less negatively charged, and so they gradually come together. Here's the same experiment, but with the ultraviolet light not turned on. And here it is again 6 minutes later, no noticeable change, so use an ultraviolet light. Well, thanks for watching. See my YouTube channel for more fun science videos like this. That includes an old one on how to make this electroscope, another about the triboelectric effect that I use to charge the glass, and one making use of the Curry temperature effect to turn a rotor. And don't forget to subscribe if you like these videos, or give a thumbs up, share with your social media, or leave a question or comment below. See you soon.